Hey learners, it's Miss Christina here. Are you ready for an adventure? Today we are going to need a snorkel mask, and I've also got a beach towel. So where do you think we might be going? If you guessed underwater, you are correct. All right, hold your breath and follow me. Okay, here we go. Let's see what fun animals we can discover. I think I might see a fish. Oh, let's get closer. Wow, look at that beautiful fish. It's so colorful. What colors do you see? Let's talk about some fish facts. These are vertebrate animals, which means that they do have a spine. They use gills to help them breathe underwater, and they can swim up to 70 miles per hour. Wow, that's really fast. But this is one of my favorite types of fish. This is what we call a puffer fish. It's not puffed up right now, which means that it does not feel threatened. When a puffer fish feels threatened, you'll see it puff up, which is why it's called a puffer fish. Let's see if we can find a puffed up puffer fish. Ooh, look at this one. This means that a predator might be nearby and the puffer fish is saying, I'm going to scare him away and get really, really puffy. And then the predator will say, ooh, that's a scary fish. Maybe I won't eat him today. That's how Mr. Pufferfish works. All right, let's keep swimming and see what other animals we can find under the sea. Wow, what did we find here? If you said an octopus, you are correct. Now, these creatures are super duper special. They are known for being highly intelligent. Some have even been shown to be able to use one of their 8 tentacles to unscrew a jar and scoop out some jelly. Now, we can't see his mantle very well here. Let me see if I can find another one for us. Oh, look at this big one. So his head or mantle is where he keeps his 3 hearts and digestive system. That's why it's so big. Octopuses belong to a group called mollusks, which have hard shells. But the octopus, even though he's a mollusk, he does not have that hard shell, which is good for him because then he can slide into tight spaces and hide from predators. Okay, let's see who else is under the sea. Who's that? Yes, a sea turtle. Did you know that sea turtles can live up to 100 years? That is a long time. And they are such great swimmers, they can hold their breath for up to 5 hours. Let's see if there are any more sea turtles out here. Oh, there's another one. Some species of sea turtles only like to eat certain things. The leatherback sea turtle will only eat jellyfish. Would you like to only eat jellyfish? No, thank you. I don't think I want to only eat jellyfish. Bye-bye. Okay, let's see what else is swimming out here. Oh, what's that sea turtle near? It looks like it's near some coral. Let's get a closer look at the coral reef. Look how beautiful. This is actually a very important part of our ecosystem. It has been around for millions of years. You don't want to touch the coral because if you touch it, you could kill pieces of it. So if you're swimming and you see a reef, make sure that you keep a safe distance. The largest coral reef in the world is called the Great Barrier Reef, and that's all the way in Australia. And it's so big that you can see it from outer space. It is 1,600 miles long. That is pretty amazing. Whoa, who is this? Yes, it is a stingray. I like them because if you look at his belly, it looks like he has a little smiley face. He's a happy stingray. Okay, now these have large flat bodies that are made of cartilage. That's the squishy part that our nose and ears are made of. Oh, who do we have here? Yes, seahorses. Now let's see if we can get a close-up look at a seahorse. Ooh, Well, let's see. It's a creature that lives in the sea. Why do you think it has the name horse in its name? Look really closely. Yes, because its head is shaped like a horse. That's how we got the name seahorse. So even though its name is seahorse, it's still a type of fish. They like warm, shallow water. And even though the mommies lay the eggs, they actually give the eggs to the daddy seahorses and they carry them in what's known as a brood pouch. Then the daddies hatch the eggs and the little baby seahorses use their cute curly tails to hang on to each other so they don't get lost. What's next? Oh, look at these cute little penguins. This is a certain type of penguins called African penguins. They prefer to live in the southern hemisphere, with the exception of the Galapagos penguins that live in Ecuador. They are very fast in the water, huh? Look at them go. Wow. Yes. Let's keep swimming. Maybe we can find some more. Oh. Now, these penguins are pretty neat. They actually have pink glands in their eyes that are for thermoregulation. Miss Christina, what is thermoregulation? Well, I'm glad you asked. That complicated word means that those pink glands help them to regulate their temperature. So if it's a really cold day, that will help them to keep their bodies cool. And if it's a really cold day, that will help them to keep their bodies warm. So it helps to keep their bodies healthy. Now, there are lots of different types of penguins. Let's see if we can find any others. The emperor penguins. Whoa. Now, these are the tallest, largest species of penguin. Some of them are 3 feet tall. That might be as tall as you. Let's see what else we can find out about these penguins. Oh, they're the only animal to inhabit the Antarctica region during the cold winter months, where it can get up to negative 75 degrees Fahrenheit. You won't find me there during that time of year. What about you? Mm-mm, no, thank you. They can face those cold wind chills, and then they live up to 15 to 20 years, and they can weigh up to 88 pounds. That is a big penguin. Let's see who's next after our penguins. Oh, do you know what these are? Orcas, yes. Wow. So orcas swim in groups known as pods. They're actually known as the wolves of the sea because they are such excellent hunters. They don't even chew their food. Can you believe that? So they'll swallow a sea lion or a seal completely whole. Don't try that at home. Oh, who's next? We've got some cute dolphins. All right, now these dolphins are highly intelligent creatures, and they're known for communicating with their family in a system called echolocation, which is a type of sonar. Let's see what they're doing. How many dolphins do you see? Well, I'm blocking one. I think I see 5 in total. How about you? Good. All right, let's keep swimming. What do we have here? Yes, these are jellyfish, another incredible underwater creature. Now, these aren't fish, even though their name says jellyfish. They're animals with no backbone and no brain and no heart. They're invertebrate creatures, which is why they have no backbone. And you might think, well, if they have no brain, no heart, how are they alive? How do they function? Well, we see these long tentacles that they have. They use those to sting and paralyze their prey and then gobble it up, and that's how they survive. Pretty incredible, huh? Okay, let's keep swimming and see what else we can find. What is that? Yes, a starfish. Now, starfish can live anywhere in the ocean's waters. They can live in warm waters or cool waters, and they're also invertebrate. Do we remember what that means? Yes, no backbone. They have five arms that all connect to that central disc in the middle. Okay, let's see what's next.
A humpback whale! Whoa!
Oh, closely. It has its little baby right next to it. So it's a mommy humpback whale and its baby humpback whale. So humpback whales are fascinating. They have the longest migration pattern of any animal in the world. Miss Christina, what's migration? This is when animals travel from one location to another location. This could be in search of warmer weather or in search of food. Let's see. I wonder if he's gonna jump, she's gonna jump again. And some other facts about humpback whales are that the female humpback whales are larger than the male humpback whales. But the males are still very special. They're the only ones that sing their famous songs, and their songs can last for hours. Humpback whales are also known for these massive tails, which are known as a fluke. And humpback whales do this big jump, which is known as a breach. It lands in a big splash. Let's see, there's another animal that's known for doing that. Oh, let's see if we can find a breach. Look at that big splash. All right, there's another sea animal that does a jump like that. Let's see if we can find it. Oh, no, it was the great white shark. Okay, swim fast. You gotta get away. Oh, that was close. Okay, let's learn some facts about the shark, but be very quiet. At birth, they already are 5 feet long, and they can grow to be 20 feet long. Ooh, even a little baby shark is very big. Their favorite foods are sea lions, seals, and even small whales. They have 300 sharp teeth. Whoa, that's a lot of teeth. Oh my goodness. Well, let's run back to the classroom before that shark sees us. All right, friends. What were some of your favorite underwater creatures that we saw today? We saw some different types of fish. Yes. I thought the octopus was very interesting. Do you remember what we call his special head on top that holds his three hearts and digestive system? Yes, it is a mantle, and he can use those tentacles to do things such as open jars and scoop out some jam. That's pretty fascinating. We also saw some jellyfish, which have no heart, no backbone, and they use their tentacles to paralyze their prey and scoop it up. What else did we see out there? Penguins! We saw African penguins and emperor penguins. Else did we see? I think we saw some seahorses, and we learned that the daddy seahorses carry the eggs in their brood pouch. And of course, we can't forget that puffer fish. What does he do when he feels threatened?
He puffs up to scare away the predators.
And our shark we saw, who has 300 teeth. All right, friends, I hope you had a great time on today's adventure, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for joining. Bye-bye.